Hello, friends. See, coming to the next topic, before we start with the next topic, you should know that what will be the next topic, how are the questions coming in the examination. The questions are regarding the applied part. Applied part means the sea level change, uska effect, the ocean acidification, uska effect, the effects of coral bleaching and all, that is the destruction of the coral reefs. We continuously hear and you will keep on seeing such things in the news. Save the coral reefs, coal is killing the coral reefs, save, responsible tourism, sustainable tourism, etc. So that means what we can conclude here, that we are destroying the coral reefs. And when we are destroying the coral reef, it is going to have some kind of an impact on us, on the coral reefs, on the ecosystem as a whole, and on the climate as a whole. Now, before we go into the next topic, that is the coral bleaching or the destruction of the coral reefs, we should know why we are saying coal is killing the corals. We should know why it is known as a race against the time, that we should conserve the coral or save the corals to save our planets. Are the corals that important that destruction of the corals may destroy our planets? Are the corals that important that is the human existence may be threatened because of the threat of the corals? Are the corals that sensitive that pollution, global warming, human destruction will cause corals? That means 10% of the already corals already gone, 58% are under the risk. So what is the effect of the corals which is having? It is causing endangered fishes, extinction of fishes, coastal erosion. That means we should know here what is the basic importance of the corals. And after knowing the basic importance of the corals, then you will only understand how the coral are at risk or how the coral is being bleached. So before we start with the coral bleaching topic in the next lecture, we should first understand the importance of the coral reefs. What we have revised in the previous lecture, let us see. There are three types of the coral reefs. For the people, for your students to have a better understanding, I am providing you how the coral reefs look like in the actually how they look like in the actual pictures. So the first diagram which is here, which I have marked in the top left corner, or my top left corner, yours also top left corner, it is which reef? It is an example of a fringing reef. It is an example of a fringing reef. The second diagram is an example of a barrier reef, the largest of all reef, having a lagoon in between. So the red color line which I have drawing is a lagoon, so this is a barrier reef. And the third, you can see somewhat heart shaped coral reef in the third figure, it is the atoll. So you can see there is a presence of a lagoon in the atoll, there is a presence of a lagoon in the barrier reef. Lagoon may be present or may not be present in the fringing reef. Yahan pe in the first diagram I have shown you there is no lagoon present. Atoll shows subsidence of a reef. Now with this understanding, let us look at the next slide. That is, what are the important services which are provided by the coral reefs? So coral reefs are most important marine habitats, obviously in the shallow tropical seas. We have known that corals can grow only in the shallow tropical seas in the chapter regarding the conditions for the formation of a coral reef. So they grow in the shallow tropical seas. They are extremely productive ecosystem and provide humans with many services. That is, they provide some kind of benefits to the human beings, and therefore we call them services. So let us see what are the services in the provided by the coral reef ecosystem. Before that, in your lectures by some other teachers regarding environment and ecology, I hope that you have done the ecosystem services. What are the different types of services provided in the ecosystem? So what are the services? The services are either provisioning services, the services are either regulating services, supporting services, or cultural services. That means the coral reefs also provide some kind of a provisioning services, some kind of a regulating service, some kind of a supporting service, and some kind of an cultural services. Now, what do you mean by provisioning, or what do you mean by regulating service, what do you mean by supporting service or cultural services? I hope that you, the other teachers have, in the environment ecology section, have cleared your these doubts. If not, let us see how these services are. So we will study each and every of these services, and this is what is the importance of the coral reef ecosystem. So the question here can be right about the importance of a coral reef, or what are the different services which are provided by the coral reefs, and this is what they are. The slides are your answers. So let us revise, starting from we are doing the importance of the coral reef. We are threatening the coral reef ecosystem, and because of this threat in the coral reef ecosystem, we have, there is a time that we may destroy our planet Earth. Our planet Earth is already showing the conditions of a stress, and therefore we need to save the coral reef ecosystem. Why? Because the coral reef ecosystem provides some of the important services. The services are provisioning services, regulating, supporting, and cultural services. Now, first, what do you mean by the provisioning services? Provisioning services are the products directly obtained from an ecosystem. So, in any ecosystem, what is an ecosystem where the you already know the definition of an ecosystem. Ecosystem is interaction of living and non-living, abiotic and abiotic things. So, provisioning services are products which we obtain from the ecosystem. Now, here we are doing the coral reef ecosystem. Here we can obtain some of the direct products from the coral reef ecosystem. One of the largest product is fishes. Coral reefs support human life and livelihoods and are important economically. How important they are. See, writing the examination, in only writing a answer in the examination without providing the facts, without providing the proper detail, without providing proper analysis, won't fetch you marks. So therefore I am giving your here this slides. You can take it as per your liking, whatever the facts you want, and try writing a very good answer. See, look here at the importance of corals. Nearly 500 million people depend directly or indirectly on the coral reefs for their livelihoods. So, much bigger amount, 500 million people is not a small amount, and this 500 million people depend directly or indirectly on the corals for their livelihoods. How do they depend? Coral reefs provide food. A square kilometer of well-managed coral reef, an area of having 1 square kilometer of a well-managed coral reef can yield 15 tons of fish and other seafood every year. So these are the sources of food, including fish. So what is the source? Have some facts. Coral reefs worldwide yield a total value of over $100 billion per year from the food alone. So annually $100 billion industry is the coral reef food industry, that is the fishes we get from the coral reef. Why there are so many fishes in the coral reef? Because the coral reef is a, if you remember, the coral reef is a shallow water ecosystem. It is a shallow water ecosystem. In the shallow water there are numerous plants which do photosynthesis. So the photosynthesis, in this photosynthesis, that means these plants are producers, and because these plants are producers, many fishes come to feed here. So these are important source of food in the ocean. It is, what is the fish? Fish is the primary source of protein for over 1 billion people. And one more thing, you can use it in SA, you can use it anywhere. It is estimated that nearly 30 million people of the poorest population in the world depend entirely on the coral reefs for their food. Which essay for climate change, how we are destroying our climate, how we are destroying our ecosystem. Use these facts, use this in your answer, highlight them in your answer, fetch good marks and get selected. This is the so this is the, what is the importance of the coral reef? Coral reef provide food. What is the economic value of that food industry? It is around $100 billion. What is the importance of this food? It is the primary source of protein. It is the primary source of protein for the poorest people population of the world. Then the second importance of coral reef is medicine, in which earlier it used to be used only in the traditional medicine, but nowadays even in the allopathic medicine, the modern day medicine, coral reefs provide. How? See, here are some examples. Some hard coral species are used in the grafting of the bones. Now, bone problem, lack of calcium, our changing lifestyles, sitting, long hours of sitting, long hours of sedentary lifestyle, lack of exercise obviously has made our bones, our body weak. In fact, even my lectures were not updated regularly because I was suffering from the sciatica and the slip disc problem. So, here the coral reefs have the answer for it. They are used in the bone grafts. These are used as a natural sunscreen products. The Caribbean sea squirt has a chemical that is used to treat difficult cancers. In fact, 50% of current cancer medication is focused on not on the coral reefs but the marine organisms which are found in the coral reefs. What does the coral reef do? The coral reef provides shelter. And what is the importance? Bone grafts, cosmetic industry and cancers. And the cancer medication. This is what you should remember. Coral reefs are also used for ornamental resources such as jewelry and in the aquariums. Now this is the common sight you have seen in hotels. Many of you may be having aquariums in the home, and for decoration in the aquarium or decorative item in the aquarium, we use corals, and for that we engage into coral mining and we destroy the corals by using this. Ornaments, jewelry is one of the use of the coral reefs, and it is also used for mining for the building materials because the corals is rich in limestone. Limestone is important rock for building materials, so it is used for building materials. So these are the provisioning services. That means the products which we can directly obtain from the coral reef ecosystem. Remember, the coral reef ecosystem provides shelter for numerous organisms, and these fishes are there. We can obtain food from many organisms, we can obtain medicinal values, we can obtain ornaments and mining for building materials. Now come to the next slide. The coral reefs also provide regulating services. What are the regulating services? Here the ecosystem, which ecosystem we are talking? We are talking of now coral reef ecosystem. We are talking of the coral reef ecosystem. This ecosystem acts as a regulator. How does it act as a regulator? See, the coral reefs provide a protective covering. If this is a coral reef, it provides a protective covering to the land, the shaded portion. So they provide a physical barrier, that is a wall, against tides, strong tides which come, against extreme weather events. What are these extreme weather events? Such as cyclones, ocean currents, tides, winds and waves hitting the coast. So the stronger ocean current, stronger tides, stronger waves which hit the coast, obviously they will erode the coastline. If the waves, tides, rainfall during the cyclones, if they hit the coast, they will engage in erosion and destruction of a coastline. Now the coral reef, as you can see here, I will draw with a blue color, they provide a physical barrier against this coastline which is in the middle, and therefore the strong waves which come, cyclones which come, this do not go and directly hit the coastline, and therefore they act as a physical barrier. So what do? They prevent the coastal erosion, flooding, loss of infrastructure. They prevent this, and because of this they serve to reduce huge cost involved with the destruction and displacement due to extreme weather events. How is this huge cost? See the fact here. This fact of just for your better understanding, this for your emphasis on the point which you are making. The coral reefs provide, in Indonesia alone they provide around $314 million is the protective service. So the Indonesia, because of the coral reefs, protects around $314 million annually because of the regulating services. What are these regulating services? So they protect the shoreline. They protect the shore. And thus prevent economic loss. They prevent economic losses. I hope that these are the shortcuts I am using, but whatever the information is there, it's already on the slide. This is just for your understanding. So here, the coral reefs, I will again highlight, these are the regulating services. They provide the regulating services, that is, they regulate something. So they protect the shoreline. How do they protect? By providing a physical barrier against what? Tides, against extreme weather events such as cyclones, against ocean current, against winds, against waves hitting the coast. So what do? They prevent coastal erosion, they prevent flooding and the loss of infrastructure. Because of this, they serve to reduce the huge cost involved with the destruction and displacement due to extreme weather events. Example is, in Indonesia alone, protective service of the coral reef is estimated at $314 million in Indonesia alone. Now let us look at the third service they provide. These are the supporting services. What are the supporting services? Supporting services are those services that are necessary for the production of all other ecosystem. That means the ecosystem is the interaction of many living and non-living things. So for that ecosystem to survive, someone has to provide a supporting service. In the terms, they have to give shelter, they have to provide the platform, they have to provide the habitat. So coral reefs engage in those supporting services, and this makes the supporting services, that is, how the supporting services are there. The coral reefs are essential part of land development or land growth. So the coral reefs help in formation of a land. Is it not a supporting service? Yes, because on that land we can stay, we can enjoy our holidays on the sea beaches. The turtles, animals, marine animals, as well as the animals which live on the shore, can survive on this land, can survive inside the water. So these are the supporting services. So they indirectly help. These are known as supporting services. How they are essential part of a land development? Because the waves which break the coral into smaller pieces, these corals are then deposited on the seashore, and thus a beautiful seashore, what we see in Maldives, what we see in Seychelles, what we see in Mauritius, white color sand beaches is formed. On the other hand, Indian beaches are generally brown, and if it's near the city, Juhu Beach, Mumbai is one of the most dirty beaches, but they are not due to the corals. Coral beaches are very white and very beautiful to look. So they are essential part of land development. The natural action of waves break the pieces of calcified coral, and these are washed up to beaches. Through a process of natural physical breakdown, these larger pieces are broken into smaller and smaller pieces and eventually become a part of a rubble building these beaches. So white colored beaches, beautiful beaches are formed due to this. So thus they help into development or growth of a land. Now the coral reefs have very high diversity. Why the coral reefs have very high diversity? Because the coral reefs are a part of shallow water ecosystem. They are a part of shallow water ecosystem. Because they are a part of shallow water ecosystem, they support plants. I am writing it as P. They support fishes, smaller fishes. So on the smaller fishes, larger fish will come to feed. So large fish LF will come to feed, and on this even larger marine organisms or larger marine fishes will come to feed, again large fish will come to feed, and thus they support a large amount of diversity, because yahan pe there is a very high food production, and therefore these coral reefs are known as a rainforest of oceans because of this immense diversity. In fact, remember, the diversity in the coral reefs is even greater than the rainforest, that is the tropical rainforest or the equatorial forest on the land, which are the highest diversity regions on the land are tropical rainforest. Coral reefs have even greater diversity than this tropical rainforest, and therefore these are known as rainforest of the oceans. So here you remember, they cover even less than 1% of the ocean floor. They cover even less than 1% of the ocean floor, but they support 25% of all marine life. So even they cover less than 1%, they support more than 25% of all marine life, with over 4000 species of fish alone. They also provide nursery or refuge or an area. So the reefs provide spawning, nursery, refuge and feeding areas for large variety of organisms, including sponges, cnidarians, worms, crustaceans, that is crabs, etc., echinoderms, that is starfish, sea urchins, sea cucumbers, sea squids, sea turtles, sea snakes, etc. So that means they have large amount of diversity, and because of this immense diversity, they are known as a rainforest of ocean. How does the large amount of diversity help us? The large amount of diversity will help us in which action? This large amount of diversity will help us in fishing. It will help us in fishing. So this large amount of diversity helps us in the fishing region. So these are the largest providers of fish. Again, not only just large amount of diversity, they also have high productivity. The highest productivity is there in the coral reefs. Productivity means the amount of food, the amount of biomass it is producing, the amount of food it is producing, it is very high. And because the amount of food it is producing is very high, so the marine organisms come to the coral reefs for their areas of food. It is, you remember, coral reefs are like a good hotel or good restaurant or good canteen or a good mess where each and every student will flock to eat the food. So they provide very high, because they have very high primary productivity. Those are the richest fishing grounds of the world. Who provides the productivity here? Zooxanthellae, by their process of photosynthesis, produce their own food, and the corals benefit from this association. We have done, because of the immense diversity of the coral reefs, there is a great deal of exchange of nutrients, and primary productivity is, or the food production is very high. Thus, the reefs are very important for, because of they are important as a source of food. These are important for sustaining the marine food chain, as they are at the base level of a food chain. Destroying the coral disturbs the marine food chain and the food web. I hope that you know the difference between the food chain and the food web. A collection of many food chains is what is a food web. So you can see here, this is where the coral ecosystem is in the diagram at the base. At the base, this is where the food is being produced. On this food, there are many primary consumers, for there are many secondary consumers, and there are top carnivorous food. If I destroy the basic food chain, this entire organisms on the top will also die or get extinct. So if we destroy the coral reef ecosystem, we are destroying the entire food pyramid of an ocean. So because of the presence of zooxanthellae who do photosynthesis, that means they produce their food, and therefore the primary productivity of the coral reef is very high, and therefore many fishes are breeding grounds, these are feeding grounds for many of the fishes. So because of these are feeding grounds, we have very high oceanic diversity also and high primary productivity also, and it also supports the marine food web. Just have an idea of how does the marine food web look like. In fact, take a screenshot, take a snapshot and keep it. What is at the base of a food web? This I have given some of the sample species. These are the producers. So these are photoautotrophs, that is the plants which will produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis. So they will engage into the photosynthesis. So what is the example here? Let's look at the highlight. I will highlight those. This is an example. Here is a phytoplankton which tap the energy from the sun to fuel the entire ocean ecosystem. So this is the base phytoplankton, seaweed, seagrass. This manufacture the food as the plants manufacture the food on the land. And on the basis of this, the other animals based on the level 2, which is the herbivorous animals, these are tiny grazing animals which eat sea phytoplanktons, and larger invertebrates such as sea urchins and which eat seaweed and the seagrass. So this is the primary consumers. Then comes the secondary consumers. These are the carnivorous animals. These are ocean's carnivorous animals. And at the top level, there are top level consumers which are larger, such as sharks, tuna, seals. So if we are destroying the base, we are destroying this entire thing which I have told you in the previous diagram. So the coral reefs ecosystems provide support to this base, provide support for this, for photosynthesis and the production of a food. So if we destroy the corals through a process known as a coral bleaching, which we will study in the next lecture, we are destroying this photo, this base, and thus we are destroying the entire food pyramid. So we were doing the, in the previous lecture, we were doing which process? We were doing the process of regular services which are provided by an ecosystem. Now, as we are doing the services which are provided by an ecosystem, we will see here what are the different services we did. We did the different services we did are where already we have done this topic, that is we have already done the reef systems. So revise this and revise this lecture, revise this lecture. We have already done this lecture, and after that look at the importance of the coral reefs in the ecosystem. So the next, we were doing the services which were provided by the coral reef ecosystem. And these are the different types of services. So the regulating services we did, we were doing the supporting services which were provided by the ocean ecosystem. So these are the regions have in the land development or the growth. These have high primary productivity, and thus they, and this is what I gave you an idea. So look at the previous. What are this? These are the supporting services. So what are the different types of supporting services? This form a part of land development or land growth. These have very high diversity, and the third supporting services is high primary productivity. High diversity helps us in fishing. High primary productivity is why the fishes are greater. Now if we are destroying this base, we are destroying the productivity of an ecosystem chain. Now they also provide some of the cultural services. What are these cultural services? These are the non-material benefits people obtain from ecosystem through spiritual enrichment maybe, or through the cognitive development, or through recreation, etc. So these are the cultural services. So the corals also provide the cultural services. What are these cultural services? This can be spiritual enrichment. If you go to Seychelles, if you go to Maldives, if you go to Mauritius, the countries are so beautiful that anyway our spirit itself gets happy. So we can say spiritual enrichment can be there, cognitive development can be there with a relaxed mind. That means this provide a recreation and tourism facilities. So these are important tourist centers. These are important recreational sites for snorkelers. I hope that you know what is the meaning of snorkeling. Snorkeling is when you wear the water gear and look at the bottom of the sea to see the various topography of an ocean. These are scuba divers who go deep into ocean, and recreational fishermen as well as the beach lovers. So these are the important tourism facilities. These are the countries. Seychelles, tourism is estimated to generate 1/5 of the GDP and over 60% of the foreign income earnings. In Maldives, tourism contributes to more than 60% of foreign exchange receipts, and 90% of government tax revenue comes from import duties and tourism related tax. And almost 40% of the workforce is employed in the industry. Even in the developed country like Australia, Great Barrier Reef generates over $1 billion per year. And sustainably managed coral reef tourism can provide significant alternative or additional source of income to poor coastal communities in the developing countries. So these are the cultural services. These are the non-material benefits people derive, and the people who provide the tourism, obviously tourism is the will help even both in all the countries. Example I gave you, take only one example as yours. Take either Seychelles, take either Maldives, take either Australia, depending on the number of word limit you are having, depending upon the nature of the question. So these are the important services. Now if you look at the economic value, this is just a graph which I have given. The economic value of the coral reefs. You can just have an idea of the coral reefs from a study made by Constanza in 2014. Coral reefs provide $352,000 per hectare per year based on their value. So per hectare of coral reef can derive, because man has become more of an economic man rather than a spiritual man, so economic importance also should be known. So the coral reefs provide an estimated $3,52,000 per hectare per year in recreation, fish habitat, coastal production. The global value of coral reefs is such big, that is $9.9 trillion. At least 94 countries and territories benefit from reef tourism. In 1923, of this reef tourism accounts for more than 50% of GDP. So is the importance of the coral reef. Why I am stressing on the economic value? So that you understand the process of coral bleaching. So that if the question is on the coral bleaching, take any of the point and tell to the examiner that what you understand. You are not just writing that we should save the coral reefs. You should also stress with the facts. Why should we stress the coral reef? So the services, so the economic value. In fact, total net benefit per year of the world's coral reef is $29 billion. Tourism and recreation accounts for $9 billion out of this amount. Coastal protection for another $9 billion. Fisheries for $5.7 billion, and biodiversity for $5 billion. The global cost of coral bleaching, that is when we are destroying the coral reefs. This is the next topic. Global cost of a coral bleaching are calculated to range from $20 billion to over $84 billion. A contribution to an employment of healthy Great Barrier Reef is estimated to 53,000 full-time jobs. So Great Barrier Reef of Australia, which is Australia is a developing country, in that developed country itself, the coral reef can provide 53,000 full-time jobs. Imagine what can be the economic value of the coral reef in a developing or a poor country. So this is why we should protect the coral reefs from getting destroyed, from dying. This destruction of the coral reef is known as a coral bleaching. We should protect the coral reef from the coral bleaching, which we are going to study in the next lecture series. Just before I end the lecture series, just have a look at this. What we have done in this lecture? We have done the importance of the coral reef ecosystem through tourism recreation, through medicine. That is, this is cultural service, medicine is provisioning service, through coastal protection, that is the regulating services, through food and fishing, provisioning services. So here with this I will end the lecture, and I hope that you have enjoyed this lecture of a coral reefs. We'll meet again with the next topic of a coral bleaching. Till the time we meet again, thank you very much.